that your real work is to figure out where your power base is and to work on the alignment of your personality, your gifts that you have to give, with the real reason why you're here. That's the number one thing you have to do, is to work on yourself and to fill yourself up and keep your cup full. Keep yourself full. Now, I used to be afraid of that. I used to be afraid, particularly from people who say, oh, she's so full of herself. Now, I embrace it. I consider it a compliment that I am full of myself. Because you only when you're full, I'm full, I'm overflowing, my cup runneth over. I have so much to offer and so much to give. And I am not afraid of honoring myself, you know? It's miraculous when you think about it. Sums up the message that I was trying to give to every single one of my viewers. You can. Keep trying. Don't give up. You have to believe. There was one woman out of all the celebrities, out of all of the famous, non-famous, infamous people. One woman, Tara Wright Trent, born and raised in a village in Zimbabwe. 11 years old, she's doing her brother's homework. She wants to go to school. Her father says, no, your boy has to go to school. You can't go to school. So she starts doing her brother's homework. She does her brother's homework. He goes to school. He gets all A's on his homework, yet he doesn't know the answers to the question. The teacher comes to the village to say, what is going on here? This boy doesn't know the answers, but his homework's perfect. She finds out that Tara Wright, his younger sister, is doing his homework. She begs the father to let Tara Wright go to school. The father says, no, she can't go to school. Finally, he marries her off. She marries at 11 and a half years old. She gets married. She has 3 children by the time she's 18 years old. A woman comes to the village from an NGO, Heifer International, and asks, what are your dreams? This is gonna make me cry. This child has never thought about what her dreams were. She says, write down your dreams. She writes down her dreams on a piece of paper and she folds them in a tin can and she buries them under a rock. The first dream was to be able to go to a school in the United States of America and get a college degree. She ends up, through some miracle of the NGO, going to the United States. She gets a college degree.
Wow.
Yes, she gets a 4-year degree in 3 years. Tara Wright Trent. She goes back to the rock in Zimbabwe. She writes her next goal on the piece of paper. She buries it under the rock. She writes, I want to get a master's degree. She goes back to the United States. She gets a master's degree. By this time, she now has 5 children. She goes back to the United States. She gets her master's degree. After the master's degree, she goes back to the rock in Zimbabwe. She writes down her final goal is to get a doctorate degree. And last year, she became Dr. Tara Wright Trent. The reason why Tara Wright Trent is my favorite guest of all time is because she represents in that one story of the little girl in a village in Zimbabwe who had a dream and the heart and depth and discipline to pursue it. She represents everything I tried to say in every show in 25 years. She literally, through her life story, sums up the message that I was trying to give to every single one of my viewers. You can. Keep trying. Don't give up. Have to believe.